How are we to move forward if we dwell on the past? That's your privilege. You get to ask that question.
Oh man, not another black rap fallback. Tired of it, but you ain't a racist, man, that's all cap. Same kids say you black this, black that. First ones to say you only half black, scrap that. Seen a lot of stories from my peers. Been having these conversations for over 20 years. My first memory as a youngin' was discrimination. Didn't know it at the time, I was the one intimidating. Teacher said, why you sitting alone, boy, go play. Two boys with a sandcastle says you ain't from it, go away. I teared, I got mad and kicked the bucket, then they cried. I was the one that got in trouble and the one got pulled aside. That day I learned that violence and anger was not the answer, but they learned that it was okay to be racist and it's cancer. And then comes the banter, but it's all jokes on a football field. Get on that black cunt, let it soak every week for 10 years. The shit that I endure, but if you speak up, no one listening. That was my biggest fear. So no, you can't retaliate. All of that anger, let it build. This ain't a drill. My brothers and sisters know how this feel. I had a white boy chase me once. He got me down, gave a smile and a look, and said, "You ain't as fast when you ain't barefoot, boonga, nigga. Don't say nothing back. It's just a way of saying that you ain't nothing but black.
You're not a real one anyway.
And that's life, dog.
You're only part.
That's life.
What part then?
That's life, and so we deal with it.
My arm? My leg? You're the black or you're not. You wanna do a DNA test? Come suck my blood.
That's a fact. I was shopping in Chatty some years back with three white friends. Walked in and out the store, there was nothing we liked there. We headed to the exit, no purchase and no dockets. The clerk came running up to me, said, "You empty your pockets." To her surprise, they both empty. I've never stolen before. She didn't question the white boys that was with me at the door. At the time, I was happy to prove her wrong, and that's a fact. But once it sunk in, I was sad to be black. I tried to justify her reasons for picking me, not the other three. Benefit of the doubt, it won't bother me. I'm used to this, I'm overthinking, probably overreacting. That's exactly how they make you think, speaking up as a black kid. That's only one instance, so many more that I face. I try to suppress so many things, believe the world's a better place. My silence has been violent, so I try to educate, only to have the feels of isolation thrown back in my face. And that's life. And that's life, though.
I was gonna search my bag.
That's life, and so we deal with it.
Because you want your blacks quiet and humble. You can't stand up, you have to sit down.
When I was little, I barely even knew that I was black. It's all the people I come across to let me know I'm that. Still to this day, they follow me like I'm hiding something. The looks I get to go inside a change room and try on something. I get anxiety walking out of store without buying something. And when they question me, they look at me like I'm lying or something. They don't know I got a job, car, and a crib. They just see another backward cap, baggy shirt, a black kid. And that's life.
Because that one time, because
and that's life,
life,
though. That's life. That's life, and so we deal with it.
I don't wanna be quiet. I don't wanna be humble. I don't wanna sit down.